Hello friends, welcome back to the prelims current affair revision series. This is Girish bringing you this lecture. So this lecture mein hum cover kar rahe defense and space related current affairs. Hope you have seen other 9 parts. This is part 10 of the video. So this lecture mein hum kya kya cover kar rahe hain, hum cover kar rahe Artemis mission ke bare mein. So first we will see what is Artemis mission, what are the important things which we have to note down in that Artemis mission, hum kya concentrate karna hai usme. उसके बाद वी विल टॉक अबाउट द एक्सेलरेशन बर्स्ट इवेंट, व्हाट इज एक्सेलरेशन बर्स्ट इवेंट, व्हाई इट वाज इन यूज एंड ऑल. आफ्टर दैट वी विल सी व्हाट इज व्योममित्रा, व्हाई इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर अस. आफ्टर दैट वी विल टॉक अबाउट द सबमरीन बेस्ड बैलिस्टिक मिसाइल K4, व्हाट इज K4 मिसाइल, व्हाट इज इट्स ओरिजिन एंड ऑल वी विल सी. आफ्टर दैट वी विल सी अबाउट द सोलर ऑर्बिटर मिशन एंड वी विल सी गैगरिन रिसर्च एंड टेस्ट कॉस्मोनॉट ट्रेनिंग सेंटर, व्हाट इज दिस. एंड फाइनली वी विल एंड विद द इंटीग्रेटेड एयर डिफेंस वेपन सिस्टम द NASAMS, व्हाट इज इट ऑल अबाउट. चलिए शुरू करते हैं. फर्स्ट द आर्टेमिस मिशन. व्हाट इज आर्टेमिस मिशन? सो नासा हैज रिसेंटली अनाउंस्ड दैट 11 एस्ट्रोनॉट्स हैव ग्रेजुएटेड फॉर देयर अपकमिंग स्पेस मिशन इंक्लूडिंग द आर्टेमिस मिशन. तो नासा इज ट्रेनिंग देयर एस्ट्रोनॉट्स फॉर द अपकमिंग मैंड मिशंस ऑफ देयर. तो इसलिए दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट. सो इन दिस 11 एस्ट्रोनॉट्स देयर इज एन इंडियन अमेरिकन, इंडो अमेरिकन हुज ओरिजिन इज इन इंडिया. तो ही इज राजाचारी, ही इज ऑल्सो देयर इन द in the list of these 11 astronauts. So what is Artemis? Artemis matlab acceleration, reconnection, turbulence and electrodynamics of moon interaction with sun. What is the main aim of this Artemis mission is that to understand the impact of the sun corona over the moon, to understand the impact of the sun rays over the moon. Because as you know, the moon is also a rocky planet, but the moon doesn't have atmosphere. Earth has atmosphere. Earth has ozone layer. Earth has various gases and Earth also has this magnetosphere. So what it is doing is, it is protecting Earth from the harmful effect of these sun rays. So yahan pe, as moon does not have all these things, here using this Artemis mission, NASA is going to, you know, it is going to understand the impact of the sun rays over the moon. Okay, that is the main objective of this Artemis mission. You can see it is to measure what happens when sun's radiation hits a rocky moon. That is the main objective of this Artemis mission. Uske baad, NASA will launch this Artemis mission in 2024. Okay, so that is the target of NASA. And also NASA is going to send a first woman astronaut to the moon. Okay, that is why this is important for us. So there is an Indo-American in this Artemis, in the 11 graduating astronauts. So that is why this is important for us. The next news, the next important current affair is the acceleration burst event. What is the acceleration burst event? The acceleration burst event is a result of mass forming into the black hole. It is a result of mass forming into the black hole. It happens, it is found that funneling of matter into a forming star happens at different rates over time. So that means, suppose this is a black hole and it consumes the mass around it. This black hole consumes everything around it. It swallows everything around it. So when it is doing that, there is a disk formed around it. So that disk is nothing but, you know, the output, you can say. So when something is going inside, something will reflect back. Action equal to minus of reaction. So there is, because of that reaction, we are seeing this, you know, circular things. You know, we have seen in this image of black hole, you know, black hole has something circular around it. We have seen that. So in this, according to this theory, this event is happening. So that means the mass is falling into the black hole. When the mass is falling into the black hole, we are seeing some kind of an event. Something is happening, like a rare event wherein which we are seeing, you know, the mass particles evolving, you know, it's coming out. That is what we will be seeing in this acceleration burst events. Sometimes the forming star will swallow up huge amount of matter around it, which results in a burst of activities around it. Okay, this is called an acceleration burst event. So when a mass is falling into the black hole, we will see a lot of activities. So they are called the acceleration burst events. So these are very rare events. And till now, we have seen only 3 such events till now. We have only 3 such events. So that is about the acceleration burst event. And there is something called the Messier Monitoring Organization, M2O. What is this Messier Monitoring Organization? So after the detection of these acceleration burst events in 2016, so astronauts around the world, they have thought that the world should know about these events, these astronomical events, which holds a lot of significance. Because the black hole, which is there, it consumes the mass around it. That means it is capturing everything around it. So there's a very important event that is happening, you know, in the universe. So in order to raise awareness about this event, this MESAR monitoring organization has been formed in 2017, in fact. Okay. So MESAR, what is MESAR? As I told you already, when the mass is being consumed, we will see some burst of activities. So these activities, how we will see? We will see them, we will receive frequencies, microwave radio frequencies we will be receiving. These are called, they are called MESAR. You know, the MESAR, it is a microwave radio frequency equivalent of that of a laser. The word stands for microwave amplification by stimulated emission of radiation, we will be seeing. It is observed using a radio telescope, and most of them are observed at centimeter wavelength. This is about the MESAR and MESAR monitoring organization. Okay, remember these two, MESAR monitoring organization and MESAR. So acceleration burst events are nothing but the events which we will witness when a mass is being collapsed into the black hole. Okay, the MESAR monitoring organization is to raise awareness about the acceleration burst events. Okay, and the MESAR is the radio frequencies, microwave radio frequencies that we will receive because of the acceleration burst events. Okay, that is what we have to remember here. Next one, Vyommitra. So Vyommitra was in use. Why it is important for us? Vyommitra is nothing but the female looking space-faring humanoid robot which is developed by ISRO. ISRO has developed this Vyommitra. Why ISRO developed this? ISRO developed this for, you know, in order to help our astronauts who are going to travel, who are going to go into the space under the Gaganyaan mission. ISRO is planning this Gaganyaan mission, wherein which it is planning to send our astronauts to space. It is a manned mission. The Gaganyaan is a manned mission, and for this mission, ISRO is going to send this robot. In this mission, ISRO is going to send this robot so that this robot will help our astronauts in the space. So, kya kya functions perform karte hain? It perform karte hain in the launch and orbital postures, responding to the environment, you know, gathering warnings. And also, it helps in replacing the carbon dioxide canisters, operating switches. There are a lot of activities wherein which it can help our astronauts. There are a lot of things, you know, which are dangerous for the astronauts to perform in space. So all such events can be performed by this Vyommitra humanoid. Okay, so this humanoid, it can understand, it is bilingual, so it can understand two languages, and it responds via speech. That is about this Vyommitra humanoid. It is developed by ISRO. Next, the K4 ballistic missile, K4 submarine ballistic missile. Why is it important here? The K4 ballistic missile is equivalent of Agni 3. It is equivalent of Agni 3. You know, Agni is part of the Integrated Guided Missile Development Program. So under this Integrated Guided Missile Development Program, we have developed various missiles. Prithvi, Agni, Akash, you know, you can remember with this shortcut. Prithvi, Agni, Akash, Trishul and Nag. All of these are developed under this Integrated Guided Missile Development Program. So in Agni, we have, you know, till Agni 5. We have developed already. So this K4 is equivalent that of a Agni 3. The difference is that the K4 is launched in submarines, using submarines. That is the difference. It is a nuclear capable intermediate range submarine launched ballistic missile. That is about the K4. It is developed by Defense Research and Development Organization, DRDO, to arm the Arihant class submarine. What is the Arihant class submarine? The Arihant class submarines are the nuclear powered submarines. The nuclear powered indigenously built submarines are the Arihant class submarines. Okay, so the remember Arihant submarines are nuclear powered. So India has completed the nuclear triad with these submarines. Nuclear triad means India can launch nuclear weapons via land, air and water. Okay, so that is important thing. The range of this, you know, these missiles is 3500 kilometers, and also the circular error probability is very low for these missiles. What is the circular error probability, CEP? So CEP determines the accuracy in a missile. The lower the CEP, higher is the accuracy. The CEP for this K4 missiles is very, very less. It is much more sophisticated than the best missiles which are available in the world. That is why this K4 missile is important for us to know. Okay, the K4 missile is the submarine launched ballistic missile. Next, Solar Orbiter mission. So the Solar Orbiter mission, it was recently launched mission, which is a collaboration between ESA, the European Space Agency, and the NASA of the America. So it is a mission dedicated to the solar and heliospheric physics. So what is heliospheric physics? Heliospheric physics is nothing but the study of corona around the sun. Okay, study of corona around the sun. The first mission that will pro it is the first mission that will provide images of sun's north and the south poles using a suite of six instruments on board, which will capture this, which will capture from the spacecraft. Okay, so it is a dedicated mission wherein which we will be capturing the images of sun, capturing of the images of the sun, that is the north pole and the south pole of the sun. That is the important thing here. It will capture the images of north pole and south pole. It is a mission between, it is a joint collaboration between NASA and the European Space Agency. So its objective is to study the heliosphere of the sun. Heliosphere is nothing but the outer layer of the sun, the corona, wherein which we will be getting all the flares and all. If this is the sun, we will be seeing all of these flares. This is nothing but the corona of the sun. Okay, so all we know, the corona is nothing but, you know, it is very famous these days because of the coronavirus. But this corona of sun is different. You know, it consists of the charged particles. It is because of the nuclear reactions that are happening within the sun. Okay, so this mission will study all of that, about the corona, about the flares, about the charged particles which are released. We will understand all of that, and it will also capture the north pole and the south pole of the sun. The next one, the Gagarin Research and Test Cosmonaut. Gagarin Research and Test Cosmonaut, it was in news. Why it was in news? It was in news because this is the center which is training Indian astronauts for the Gaganyaan mission. This is the center which is training Indian astronauts for the Gaganyaan mission. Gaganyaan is a manned mission of India, wherein which India is sending astronauts to space. So this Gagarin Research and Test Cosmonaut Training Center is in Moscow, Russia. It is training currently four Indian pilots. You know, because we have seen recently in news that because of the coronavirus pandemic, the training is being delayed. And this full program includes the basic and generic astronaut training, followed by the activities, you know, where what has to be done in the space, what are the important things that the astronauts has to carry out in space. Everything is being trained in this mission. The Russia has, you know, experience in this space training. Why? Because Russia is part of the International Space Station. And Russia is part of this. Russia has a seat in this International Space Station. So Russia will send Russian astronauts, you know, every year for the International Space Station. So Russia has experience in this international space manned missions. So Russia is training the Indian astronauts. So at the end of the training modules in India and Russia, one or two, you know, there are two to three people who are going into the space. That is about the Gaganyaan mission. Next one, Integrated Air Defense Weapon System, IADWS. Why this was in news? This was in news because US Department of State has approved the sale of this Integrated Air Defense Weapon System to India. It is also known as, this weapon system is also known as NASAMS. You know, the NASAMS 2 is a joint collaboration between a US company and the Norway company. This Integrated Air Defense Weapon System is also being deployed in Washington, wherein which the White House exists in United States. This air defense weapon system will help in protecting the airspace of that region. This weapon system includes radars, launchers, targeting and the guided systems. It is an advanced medium range air-to-air missile and Stinger missiles related, and also it will have a lot of related equipment and support. Okay, that's why this is important, the NASAMS. Okay, now let's revise what we have studied. We have seen Artemis mission. Artemis mission is the mission of NASA, wherein which NASA is going to send astronauts to moon, where they will study the impact of sun over the moon, impact of sun radiation over the moon surface. Next is the acceleration burst events. This acceleration burst event is that event where when the mass is collapsing into the black hole, we will observe a lot of burst events. That is called the acceleration burst events. Next is Vyommitra. Vyommitra is the humanoid developed by ISRO, wherein which this humanoid will be helping astronauts in the Gaganyaan mission in the space. Next is submarine launched K-4 ballistic missile. It is equal to Agni 3. It is naval version of Agni. Next is solar orbiter mission. The solar orbiter mission is to study the heliosphere, which is nothing but the corona of the sun. It is joint collaboration between the ESA, European Space Agency, and NASA. Next is Gagarin Research and Test Cosmonaut Training Center in Moscow, Russia. Here, Indian astronauts are being trained for Gaganyaan mission. Next is the Integrated Air Defense Weapon System. This Integrated Air Defense Weapon System, you know, this belongs to America and Norway. It's a joint collaboration between America and Norway, and the US Department of Defense has approved its sale for India. Okay, so So that's it, friends, in this lecture. I'll see you again in the next lecture. Till then, keep revising and stay focused. Jai Hind.